Thanks again for this very nice introduction from your side. I'm trying to start my presentation. Can you see the presentation already? No.
No, we see you.
Okay, so now I'm sharing my presentation.
Better.
Yeah. Thanks again for the introduction and thanks to Andreas for handing over into the customer service. I'm just want to show you something about customer service in Lipe, Harbor Mobile creates in cranes in general, and also some advantages we faced during the Corona crisis. So this is a small outline. I will also try to be in time. So if I'm not in time, please interrupt me. As I said, customer service introduction, we developed during the last 2 years a remote service tool, and we used it in June for assembling a new crane in Argentina. Yeah, our customer service, we are providing the services all over the world. As Andreas said, we have 40 subsidiaries all over the world. We have 400 engineers in place and 130 of them here in Rostock. They are for offshore crane, ship cranes, harbor mobile crates, and reach stackers. And all our engineers are high skilled, high qualified. We are doing a factory training with them to bring them on the level we expected from our engineers in the field, and also what the customer expect from us. The first step, as Andreas mentioned, the first part of the customer service is the testing here in Rostock on the test bench. You can see it here on this picture. This is the factory here in Rostock, direct in the Überseehafen, in the port. We are doing our own testing procedure. We are testing all the electrical and hydraulic installations and components, and we do all adjustments. Then we are also responsible, or we are part of the shipment. As Andreas also said, it's possible to drive the cranes direct on the vessel. We can lift them, we can disassemble the crane, we can do partial disassembling. So it's up to the customer and how he wants to have the crane. Then we have our maritime training center with two simulators here in Rostock. We have five trainers at the moment for each type of crane. And we are doing several trainings like maintenance training, technical trainings, operator trainings. And this is not only if the customer is purchasing or buying the crane, it's also possible afterwards if he has some changes into his technical stuff, that we can also do the training here or even on site. As I said, we have at the moment 408 experienced engineers, our 40 service centers all over the world, and we are available all the time, or we have also a lot of service contract in place. We are responsible for upgrades and retrofits. You can imagine that some ports get different advantages, and it's also possible to retrofit or upgrade the crane and even extend the lifetime. And spare parts, we have here our production stock and also our spare parts stock. We are available all the time. And just give me a short review into the past. For each crane, when we have to assemble a crane somewhere in the world, we send most likely two engineers from the factory into the field, into the world. And during this Corona crisis virus, which is still in place, we reduced our engineers from normally 40 in the world down to one. So we had from March to June, one engineer still in Africa supporting a customer. And we started to developing this kind of remote service tool 2 years ago, together with our colleagues from Lansing. It's possible to have audio and video call, a chat function, screen sharing, image and document exchange, and whiteboard functions. And it's in real time. You are always available. Everybody can speak, hear, shout, everything in time. And let me come to the success story of our remote tool. As I said in the introduction, we shipped LHM 420 to Argentina. It was the first LHM 420 in Argentina, so also pretty new machine for our colleagues. For sure, they have seen it here on a test bench when they have been in Rostock for the training, but they never assembled such a crane on their own. As I said, normally we are sending two engineers through the world, and in this time it wasn't possible. But the crane was on this way, and we had to find a decision how to manage the assembly works. And we are lucky to have this tool in place, and we decided, let's try. We can only win if this tool is working and our engineers are doing what they are doing. We started, and here you can see this is from the unloading of the parts. So the crane was totally disassembled, and one of our technical advisors here in the office, he made screenshots from above to make the assembly area clear. He wrote a 60-page long assembly instruction for our colleagues in Argentina, just to have something in their hand to prepare themselves for the assembling work. And you can see some pictures out of the tool. So you can see two mobile cranes lifting the slewing column on the undercarriage. So the main task was to organize the Wi-Fi in the port, that we have a really good connection to have everything what we can see. And here you see our engineer. He was normally planned to go to Argentina to assemble the crane, and unfortunately he couldn't go there. But we asked him to make this project with our remote tool. And he said, I will do. He adapted his working time to the Argentina time zone. There are time difference of 6 hours at the moment. So he was always available for our engineers on site, and guided them, told them, you have to connect the cranes there. Please go there, check everything that we are safe at all. Here are some slides out of this tool we took during the assembly work, just to show you how it looks like, how the picture was, the video quality is, because it's a live stream, so it's a really good connection. And what is the summary of this advantage? We built the crane. I think we took 2 days more than expected, so we were really fast in time. We had no safety issues, no incident, nothing. And the customer was also happy, because there were only two decides. There, we put the crane in parts somewhere in stock and wait until we can travel, or we do this advantage, and the customer is happy, he can use the crane now. Otherwise, the crane would be still disassembled somewhere in the stock. And you can also follow the story about this assembly work, and also about the remote tool, on liepherr.com. So, this is something what we would call service reliability in a very difficult time at the moment. So, and I think this is all of my presentation. I hope I'm still in time.
Yes, you are. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.